Welcome back, my friends, to the Let's Play of Morocco. We are capturing our homeland, just like my dad told me to. Secure your border, my son, he bequeathed to me when I was a child, and so I have. Or something like that. That may have been in a book I read. Instead, it's hard to tell. The memories back then so fuzzy. Alright, so we have a bunch of people moving over towards Hastings. Very soon, our 10 turns of waiting will come due. We do have great works of art somewhere, don't we? Ah, Phidias showing the frieze of the Parthenon to his friends. Is a great work that we captured from the Portuguese. No wonder it has a very confusing title. It's a work, it's a meta work of art. So this is helping the Parthenon out. I'd like to move it. But I'm not really sure how to do so. It is giving us two culture and creating tourism for us. Did we get another great work of art somewhere? Yes. And our amphitheater here is showing...
How do you know, poor fool? Perhaps out there, somewhere, someone is sighing for your absence. And with this thought, my soul begins to breathe.
All right, two canzoniere. Canzoniere? I don't even know exactly where this is from. But that is popping up. Let's actually, can we put that in the palace? Oh, it's a great work of writing. Can we store it in our great library? I guess I do not know how. Let me take a quick look. Well, I suppose I won't worry about it. All right, the trebuchet is closing in. We're gonna leave these guys in position. We want their health high for our inevitable siege of Porto. Is anyone not doing anything? I suppose we will find out. Our road network is commencing. Our units are healing, preparing for war. So these guys are tough, and they're fortified, and they're healing every turn, which means they mostly shrug off, or actually just heal up the majority of the damage they're taking. Almady was influenced by spies.
Don't clap too hard, it's a very old building.
A hilarious quote from John Osborne about the Tower of Pisa. Leaning Tower of Pisa. Plus 25% generation of great people in all cities. That's excellent. The free great person of our choice appears. The great person of our choice, a scientist or an engineer, most likely. All right, so these guys have leveled up. We can give them drill level 2. Medic. Allows them to heal adjacent units. Defense from ranged attacks. We're gonna go with ranged defense. I'm gonna make them invaluable against cities which have primarily ranged attacks. Okay, Albany, shenanigans. Get a free great person. So many things to choose from. Musicians, writers, and artists all create major works of art or can start a golden age. Scientists can push us further down the road towards awesomeness in knowledge. And engineers can be used to really, really quickly produce generally wonders or to create powerful production focused tiles. We're not ready to choose yet. We could bust out the globe to get a free great writer immediately. What's coming up in our research? The porcelain tower would be nice, but we'll need another social policy before we can get there, and unfortunately, we'll have to start rationalism without finishing commerce, so we'll have to wait two more social policies to wrap up commerce if we want the porcelain tower. Porcelain tower is very significant when it comes to research, as it increases the amount of science generated from research agreements by 50%, which is fantastic because then you get more than your opponent. So a tactic we already take with our with our trade routes. Everyone benefits, we benefit more. One for you, three for me, is the Moroccan way. The great scientist. Let us build a great scientist, as it will help us get to that. It'll help us research everything we need to. The great engineer is nice when you have something already ready to go. We don't at the moment. So let us build a great scientist, and then we will convert some terrain tile. This wine. Or perhaps this tile itself here. This wine. We have a bunch of wine. Let us build another academy here. Great tile improvements will connect strategic resources on this tile to the trade route. We'll lose one gold because there's no plantation here, but we'll gain 8 science from working this tile. Observe. I forgot to look at his name again. And because our primary city has a bunch of science-producing wonders, we are standing in good stead. Let's do produce a circus. It'll take 2 turns to get our happiness up to above 0. Unit needs new orders. We're no longer friends with Albany, so unfortunately, our scouts can't travel into their territory anymore without making them unhappy. The Galeas moves about. These guys are closing in. These are all healed up. These longbowmen are out of position.
Harizeste. Proserku.
does say who they're allied and who they're at war with. If we attack now, we can totally crush Hastings. Where's that trebuchet? It's on its way. Elizabeth's pissed.
Oh, it's you.
Let's simply declare war. We'll cancel two of our trade routes, which are generating a good bit of gold for both of us. And Jerusalem, which we do not know where it is, will declare war on us. Alright, so now the world will know of our treachery. We did betray our word. We sold them. It was not a military buildup. All to get a first strike. So let us make the best of it. Net have like no health because, like I said, they barely won a duel to the and you. Why don't you fix up the place as you see fit? Okay. Hack into these archers with our long swordsmen. We're gonna trample these scouts with our knights. Slaying them. The knights are out of moves. These lance necked will move up here. These guys will simply fortify. The roads let us get much closer with these Landschnecht. Definitely want to fight before our Landschnecht become obsolete. They are still revolting for a couple turns. They've always been revolting. Now they're rebelling. These archers should get into position to attack. And things are on the move through our network of roads. We'll keep an eye down here. See exactly who gets attacked and what. Those log swords gonna take a beating. We're gonna have to pull them out. Not such a problem. Alright, we connected a road to Panama City. They are pleased with that, and it has reinforced our influence with them. We're setting up for a ranged attack. Can I not attack the city? They should be within range. Am I missing something? can't see a good reason why we'd have to get closer, but I suppose we must. These guys will move. That's not going to be the healthiest thing for them to do, but whatever. Fine, get closer if you must. All right, we connected that. You two complete this road here. These Landschnecht are ready to go. And it will take them only a couple turns to travel this way thanks to our road network. Here, we finished one of the happiness buildings. Let's finish the Colosseum and our population growth will return to normal. Here, let's finish the Colosseum as well. Get our happiness on track. Those archers have moved into the city. Painful for us. Fortunately, we have Florence here backing us up. These guys are going to go back and heal in the city of Marrakech. Our archers will take this nice fortified position as a ranged unit that can attack Hastings from there. Very pleasant. The knights, they have a penalty versus cities. This is not their strong suit. We're actually going to send them to intercept anything coming from York and to kind of scout around. We have three Landschnecht surrounding this city, and our crossbowmen. It is definitely time to attack it. It's only got one ranged attack. Our guys can actually heal up from pillaging, and we're going to be earning money for each of these attacks. You want to build a road network to Lisbon. Let's see. Yes. Greece impressed Almaty with its culture. Okay, there's another 29 gold for us. And then these three can all heal, and while it attacks one of them, the other two will be getting healthier. So a war of attrition will be fought. Looks like it's time for our trebuchet. Position itself. As well as our great general. And some more archers. All right, now we may be falling behind other non-fighting races civilizations. So no, their city and their archers get to attack, which reduces this poor Landschnecht to basically nothing. These cities haven't had defensive units in them, which has made them very easy to conquer. These pikemen will form up and charge. Deal some nice damage. Thank you, Florence.
Joyfully to the breeze, royal Odysseus spread his sail, and with his rudder, skillfully he steered.
Thank you, Homer, from the Odyssey. Caraval, observatory, plus 50% science in a city, must be built next to a mountain. This is actually a building that our first move of the game we were thinking about. We moved next to a mountain. And we can now faster embarked movement, and embarked units can now cross oceans. The caraval is the first unit a fast unit that can now enter ocean. It does fight as a naval melee unit, which means it can't attack land units, but is an excellent ship-to-ship. The observatory will increase science by an incredible amount here in Marrakech. And we are now not uber unhappy. Let's go ahead and complete the globe. The observatory. Let's go for the observatory first. This will pay dividends. The globe is nice. Not everything I need. Take two turns to attack that. I would rather be somewhere else. Larry Trebuchet, I don't know why you had to get so close. These guys, I'm going to pillage, which will restore some of their health. I want to back them out. We have numerous units to take their place. Set up for ranged attack, and then unleash. Perhaps it's a line of sight thing for our other guys. Nice and effective. These guys are going to pillage so as to heal themselves. Gain us 9 gold. And then they're going to spend all that newly found health attacking, getting us more gold. These guys are going to move up. Our great general is going to move into the midst of everyone, increasing their combat power. Maybe a little late, unfortunately. Our archer is going to arch. No, pay attention. Some spy stole stuff from us. We're going to keep attacking. Do we get XP for that? Survey says no. And these landsknechts will take the city. Alright, let us view this city. It has no buildings. It's in a poor place, and we don't want to puppet nor take over it. So we will raise it to the ground. We also gain 44 gold for pillaging it. And now, how close are we to a social policy? We're still more than 10 turns away. How close are we to architecture? About 10 turns away. Very well. That is what we will do. So despite having our own spy set up, someone did steal something from us. He is working counterintelligence, and this is where we're being attacked. So hopefully he'll get better at his job sometime soon. So that is all she wrote for Hastings. Here, you heal. It must be this jungle. It's reducing our line of sight. Seriously, we can't attack. Our great general, El Cid, is nothing more for him to commit to over here. So let's move. Our fort is complete, but was it ever really necessary? Scouts. All right, the war with the last bastion of Portuguese influence continues. Unit promotion. Plus 50 combat strength versus fortified units and cities. 15% range combat strength against rough units. We're going to take the 50%. That will stack with its already 200% bonus. It's going to be a great boon to us immediately. These guys sacked a city. We can go for drill 2. We can go for medic. Defense against ranged. We could use a little more medic in the army. defense against ranged is fantastic. Let's go with let's go with defense against range for this time. Medic we can do later. I want them to sit there and heal. We captured another worker. Let's just delete this unit. We get 11 gold for selling it. It reduces our upkeep by 3 gold. And our other trebuchet is ready to go. And it has attacks against flatland, seems like the way to go. So we'll give it accuracy. Choose production. This place can produce gold for us. It will be gone before it is out of resistance mode. Unit needs order. Why don't you simply explore? We want this tile. We can work that tile. 1, 2, 3. Yes, we can. And the quickest way to take it over is boom. Stop. So now we have a shrine there. And it's producing a boatload of faith, as well as 2 gold, 2 production, and it attaches silver to our network, I believe. Maybe that hasn't triggered yet. Also, City Country Rabbit in our capital has been established. Excellent. Unit needs some orders. This worker. Where is the road? Okay, I want to establish. Let's establish a road to Florence. They seem really dumb about where they build roads. So just stop. Just stop. I don't want to attack Brussels. I think they will surrender to us once Portugal is gone. El Cid will follow the trebuchet. Let's have these guys catch a breather here. Them as well. Heal. Okay, excellent damage there. Roads all connected. We will want to build on this copper mine, as it is in our territory. We won't be able to work it at our city, but it will provide us copper, which we already have, but a nice game. I assume Brussels is running out of steam over there. These guys heal. Pull these guys back. I don't think they can be attacked with this fresh Landschnecht up here in preparation for the sack of Porto. Maybe not next turn, but soon. Route canceled. You guys go there. You guys. See, they're building roads. Probably don't need more road than that. Don't need too much road. Why don't you head down here? We'll connect Cape Town to our capital as well. They attack our archers. Cape Town is under attack by barbarians. Something that's been going on all game. Poor guys. Use production. Okay, we're looking all happy again. Let's go with the Globe Theater. See if we can beat people out on that. Let's build a cargo ship to establish a sea trade route, since we have two open trade routes, and that is kind of our jam. What is there to see here? They have a great general and a trebuchet. That's going to be a pain in the butt. Plus, we're limited by being very close to Brussels. Let's see about wrapping up this whole Portugal-Brussels thing. Okay, some joint maneuvers here with our ally are causing us a little bit of trouble because they're in our way, but it's fine if they take the brunt of the action, I suppose. Let's simply return back from whence we came, having scouted them out with our knights. Let's have these guys move here. We can pillage this now it's not in our territory anymore. There are no cities around to benefit from it, so why not? Return to full health. These guys, let's move them back into our territory where they can heal. You move here. I'll build a road to Florence. Still sick. I know. Like Alexander the Great, I may die before my great conquest is complete. These Landschnecht, let's make sure no one's coming at us through Brussels. And send some people to keep Brussels busy. Alright, Porto will fall next turn. England is declaring something. Probably they're protecting Cape Town. Incredibly inefficiently, I suspect, but still. We're losing our grasp on Florence, which would be a shame. Almaty.
They're rising all at once, was as the sound of thunder.
One thing
heard
at a time.
Remote.
The Sistine Chapel is now an available wonder. That's 25% culture in all cities, and it can host great works of art. The Opera House, can be built anywhere, increases cultural output, and can host great works of art. Musicians' guilds help produce great musicians and can host great works of music. Lastly, Brazilwood Camp culture increased. I don't think that's anything that we can do. Now, it is time. Archers, you go first. for a little bit of XP. Siege unit, your turn. Knock it down, Landschnecht.
Conheça deste conflito. Terei de consultar o meu regente.
All right. Worry not. The Portuguese are honorable fighters and noble, yeah, kind of noble. And this city, once again, poorly placed, of no real benefit to us, unfortunately, must be razed to the ground. We do capture a decent amount of gold from it. We can go in here, we can look. They have basically nothing, it will take a while. Unhappiness in my empire is quite high as we work through the ramifications of all this. Ah! Time to purchase a courthouse. My unhappiness dropped by 4 just from that single purchase. Matter of fact, now that I think about it, let's purchase a zoo. And lower it a bit more. The zoo here as well. Our unhappiness drops from negative 11 to 3. Negative 3. Musician guilds. Okay, lots has happened. England is protecting Cape Town, we talked about that. Florence is just barely with us, maybe 2 more turns. They want to discover a natural resource, that's just not gonna happen. We do appreciate their military assistance. So let us make a gift to them of 500 gold. Our vast reserves of gold have dwindled significantly, but it's all to the good. Almany has declared war on Portugal and England for us because we connected a road to them, making us their one and only allies for like 4 turns. But that's fine. A unit has gained a promotion. Once again, it's hard to turn on cover for a unit that is meant to pillage near enemy cities. Brussels, let's see, Portugal is no longer the ally of Brussels, of course. Almany, Florence. So this road went over quite well with Almany. They are quite pleased. Brussels, please. Let's make peace. All right, Brussels is pleased to go back to neutral with us because, of course, we would wreck them if we felt like it. But we don't, because we want a lot of different trading partners. I don't know where Jerusalem is, but they're in trouble if they get close to us. So let's finish up this turn. Pleasantly, we can move military units past Brussels. They will be annoyed temporarily, but at least they won't be dead. Okay, let's get this trebuchet closer. That's the really important one. We can attack this. Our knights are going to take a beating. Let's get some damage in on this catapult. We should do some serious damage to it since it got caught out in the open. Plus, it's worth XP to our knights. And our knights can then retreat out of range of the city, which is the beautiful part. Now, that thing might set up and shoot our knights. Totally can. It's got the range. But then it will be trapped. Alright, our swordsmen are ready to go. They would make the ideal medics if we could ever get them leveled up. We made peace with Brussels because we're such nice guys. You want these units to heal up. These lands necked are ready to go. Let's send them out that way. There are many unguarded civilian units of mine. You. I don't think we need all the workers we have. We captured many workers. Construct a copper mine. You're done. And let's end this video right here. All right, so Hastings, another city razed to the ground. I swear it's due to the inefficiency of where the AI builds them, not to some particular bent that... I mean, it's not like Dad told me to burn everything and salt the earth. I learned that in books. So, just another unsightly city removed from my landscape. But really, owning cities is a big responsibility and burden on your empire. So you really have to be very, very selective about the cities you own. Or... you face vastly increased social policy requirements, as well as religion, golden age, all sorts of things become more expensive and harder to achieve. So we are focusing on a very tall empire, very high population, and a few decent cities. Four cities seems like the optimal number. I think London will be the next fourth city. The next city that we want to claim. There's Jerusalem, who hates us. I can see why they're English. I hope Panama City can handle them. Maybe I should... I'm glad I sent some Landschnecht over there. These guys, once they heal up, perhaps I will send them that way. Why don't you heal up in Marrakech, for that matter? Oh, thank you, Rhodes. Rhodes are so good. So we're putting them in a better position. And, otherwise, things are going quite well. Of course, we have not been attacked ourselves because, for the most part, we prepared quite carefully and have crushed our enemies quite quickly. Portugal has been eliminated from the game, but they were kind of low on the totem pole to begin with. And once we're done with London, then we could leave York for London if it weren't pretty much in the path of our army. Not much I can do about that for you guys. But it would be nice to leave London in the game, just take their capital. We shall see. They may never rise again as a true power. The question is, though, have other people... shot ahead of us. Here's our score, which says we are slightly ahead of Alexander. While we're spending all these resources on fighting and combating unhappiness and such, has the rest of the world passed us by? We're gonna have to turn this struggle into a meaningful victory for ourselves. There's no guarantee that that's actually gonna work out. Until next time, though, when we will find out, we'll press the assault on London, and hopefully peace will be restored in a couple episodes. Until then, farewell, my friends.